Our first guests tonight are, among many other things, the hosts of Family Game Fight, which airs Wednesday nights on NBC. Please welcome back to the show two of my favorites here together for the first time, Kristen Bell and Dax Shepard.
Hello, Seth.
Seth, you look so tan.
Thank you. I have had a two-week hiatus and have been, sadly, my least favorite place with my children, which is outside. I'm a little embarrassed. I saw a shot of your room before you guys came in, and I guessed completely wrong as to who was going to sit in what chair.
There's a very specific reason why. I normally would Dax would sit here. This is his lazy boy. This is his throne. But his good side is that side, and my good side is this side. So under no circumstance will you ever see us in the reverse if we're together.
If this was flipped, people would scream.
You'd puke.
You'd puke.
Watch this. Turn your head that way. Ready?
Obviously, we're going to edit that out. That was too horrifying to be on television.
Yeah.
Yeah, this side, zero career. This side, hey, let's do a game show.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And now, the interesting thing to me is it never occurred to you guys to move the chairs.
Well, it did, Seth, but that's a lot of work. This is a tight area. We have a throw rug in here that's cumbersome and gets wound up in the feet.
Sticky. And this room is really, you're pretty much seeing the whole of the room. It's a little attic room.
There's also some juju to protect because that is the chair I sit in for the podcast, and it's been good for our family. We don't want to tinker with that.
Gotcha. I have much respect for that. I want to talk about the show, which is very family-oriented, but I also want to ask, you guys got a very prime spot, which is you aired after the closing ceremonies of the Olympics. And I'm wondering, were you guys a family that enjoyed the Olympics?
Some more than others.
Yeah, I'm obsessed with the Summer Olympics specifically, and largely because years ago, probably we're going on 15 years of this, I am always on high alert for any kind of genitalia that comes loose during the sprinting or the jumping or the hurdles, and only male genitalia. I find it.
I can confirm all of this.
It's so amusing when that thing just starts doing whatever it wants to do, despite what the athlete's doing. And so I'm on a bit of a text chain with some friends that we kind of gather these photos and we share them if we're ever lucky enough to see something. And it's the luckiest I've ever been in over a decade of doing this, which we were watching, and someone did a triple jump, and then when they landed, and then when they stood up to spin, we got something that's never been gotten in this text thread, which was bottom pole.
Anus.
Wow.
And it's so rare. And then on top of it, this seems impossible, but on top of it, when the malfunction happened, the wardrobe malfunction, then the garment became kind of a scoop for the sand. And so when he stood up and that got exposed, there was also very sizable droplets of sand falling out of the bottom. And when I sent the photo, I had to be very clear to people, we're not dealing with a mishap gastrointestinally. This is sand. We didn't get the holy grail.
Some people watch the Olympics for the athlete's performance and their dedication to the sport. Others watch the Olympics for the fails, the wardrobe malfunctions. Well,
just the zhuzh, the
edginess.
The thing you can't plan for in training. You can train at elevation, but still, when you're at full volume sprint, and whatever day it is, humidity, all these things are factors. There's no saying what's going to happen down there.
And I'll just say this. When you have a world event and you put everyone in spandex, what do you expect?
What did everyone expect?
Because there are a lot of other, pictures in this text chain that I've seen where, people, the guys can get pretty excited when they win a gold medal.
And she's euphemizing, of course, some of the contestants become erect during the medal ceremony.
Happened
a few times. That's happened. That's sincere, Seth.
That's shocking to me and great to know. Have you sort of collected people on this text chain over the years? Do you find more enthusiasts for this kind of Olympic, viewing style?
Well, what happened was I was kind of describing to the folks that listen to the podcast what I just explained to you about this incredible malfunction I witnessed. And then it occurred to me, oh my God, there's an army of over a million folks that potentially are also watching the Olympics. So I just said, if anyone sees anything, like I got that, I'm not even professional. I'm only watching, you know, an hour of Olympics a day, and I caught that. So God knows what's out there. So I kind of enlisted all of them, and I gave out our email and said, hey, if you find anything. So it's kind of our first political cause, or our first cause.
Yeah.
As a group.
Spandex wardrobe malfunctions.
I just like that even when you become, as a male athlete, no matter how, you know, how incredibly fit you become, there's no way to make that part of the body not be floppy.
It's the poorest design, Seth, because there's all this equipment, and then they were like, where should we put it? And we said, well, where's the most friction on the body? Right in the thighs. All right, let's put it out in front of that, not like concealed somehow within. No, right out in front, right where the action is, let's put all this cumbersome business in there.
It's almost like they put it there to tell you not to sprint.
Yes, be careful is what it says to me when I see a nude male. I'm nervous for myself when I look in the mirror. But I want to be clear, too. I've really thought through the ethics of this. And my conclusion is, like, if a woman were to dedicate her entire life to the 400, you know, hurdles, not cool for me to try to watch her bouncing about. That's not cool.
Yeah.
But as a man, I know that if I was running my fastest and winning, and also you were enjoying watching my business flop around, that's just another win for me.
I can confirm. I'm the ethics police in our house, and he doesn't snap any. None of the females are a part of this. It's all males.
Which is not to say I haven't seen some female wardrobe malfunctions.
But
they exist.
We brushed past it. We're not here for that. We're here for the funny part. And there's one funny body part among both males and females and everyone in between. And it's that thing on the front.
It makes me sad that there isn't another season of The Good Place where there could be a whole episode discussing the ethics.
Yeah, thanks for snapping a picture of someone's genitalia without their knowledge.
Yeah, when you say it that way, it makes I feel nervous.